में बहता है कि मानो क्लासरूम भी इनके स्ट्रीट प्ले का मैदान बन जाता है। और इन्हीं के साथ आवत है हमार भाया, हमार मदबल आर्श भाया। ई जो है ये बहुत ही अच्छा लिखत है, बोलन माँ भी बहुत माहिर है, ऊपर से का ड्रामा करत है, गिटार भी बजावत है। ई भाया इतने इन्फ्लुएंशियल है कि खुदई के साथ साथ सबई का कॉन्फिडेंस हिलाई देत है। यारो, दोस्ती में कोई रूल नहीं होता और इसे सिखाने का कोई स्कूल नहीं होता। सो हाउ कैन वन मिस द फ्रेंड्स ऑफ माई एल्बम रिदम गोपी प्रेया एंड रेया। दे आर एन इंस्पिरेशन, सपोर्ट एंड मोटिवेशन फॉर ईच अदर। एंड नॉट टू फॉरगेट दैट व्हेन वुमेन सपोर्ट ईच अदर, इनक्रेडिबल थिंग्स कैन हैपन। और हाँ, जरा गौर फरमाइए, इनकी दोस्ती के दास्ता तो क्लासरूम से लेकर डाइनिंग हॉल तक मशहूर है। जब तक एक का खाना ना खत्म हो तो दूसरे का वहां से उठना नामंजूर है। नाउ प्रेजेंटिंग द रोनाल्डो एंड मेसी ऑफ दिस क्लास। उरा एंड सौम्या अय्यर। ऐसा लगता है कि फुटबॉल ने तो इनका दिल कुछ इस तरह से छू लिया है कि मानो फुटबॉल ना हो तो जिंदगी क्या है। Their ability to cheer up the spirits of everyone around them makes them a precious jewel of this class. God created heaven and earth, and the rest was all managed by them. And for the final group in my photo essay that will hook the viewers include the luminous leaders. From Teachers' Day to Sports Day to Navrais to Navfest to TEDx to managing innumerable inter-house competitions to taking part in various inter-school competitions to council meetings to fun fair to surprise bag check. Oof! And the list goes on. But these two girls, I swear, are omnipresent. No wonder that a proxy list, I mean a duty list, needs to be made on their name. Ananya, Lisa, Lisa, Ananya, on duty, on duty, on duty. A council member is never off duty. And it is because of this commitment and dedication that our new age Elsa Kalisa and Princess Moana Ananya deserves a spot in the latest edition of the Forbes list of 100 most powerful leaders of the world. पर पिक्चर अभी बाकी है मेरे दोस्त। आफ्टर रिव्यूइंग माय पर्सनल कलेक्शन ऑफ आर्काइव्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ सेलिब्रिटी कैलेंडर, द पैप्स वर ऑस्ट्रक एंड ऑल दे कुड से वाज नगर में ढिंडोरा पिटवा दो मामा। बच्चे बड़े सबसे कह देना ये 12वीं के शेर आ रहे हैं दुनिया में तूफान मचाने। तो कुछ इस तरह हंसते हंसाते बीता हमारा ये साल। वो क्लासरूम की मस्ती, वो ब्रिज पे बिताए हुए हसीन पल, और वो एग्जाम के पहले वाले डाउट सॉल्विंग सेशंस मेरे दिल में याद बनकर समा गए हैं। फोटोग्राफ्स एंड मेमोरीज, ऑल दैट आई विल हैव नाउ आर दीज टू रिमेम्बर यू। टेक मी टू दैट टाइम, back to those happier days when I called you mine, my class 12E. And if ever there comes a day when we can't be together, we shall keep each other in our heart and stay there forever. Photographs and memories, all the love you gave to me, these memories are too good to be true. And now that's all I'm left of you. For every picture has a story to say.
Thank you, ma'am. I'd love to get a copy of that calendar. Do save me one. Coming up is Adarsh Sashidhar, head boy, to give his valedictorian speech.
Respected chairperson, principal ma'am, distinguished chief guest, in charges, teachers, families, and for one last time, batch of 2020. It is said, and I quote, "We do not fear the unknown. What we fear is giving up the known." What each of us sitting here is facing right now is a fear of change. Change that faces us as we step into the unfamiliar world. Change that faces our families as we leave behind an empty nest. And that which faces our dear teachers who part tonight with undoubtedly the most talented batch that they have ever known. But when I talk about the fear of change, I wonder, for a boy who has moved across 6 to 7 schools, why does that fear of change still persist today? Many of us entered those school gates with that very uncertainty 11 to 12 years ago, for some 5 years, maybe for some just 2 years ago. So we have seen the unfamiliar before, and we have faced it. Then why is the change still a fear? It shouldn't be. After all, my first day 3 years ago till this very moment constantly reminds me that stepping away from the familiar and thus inviting change could prove to be the best decision you can ever make. Tonight, I honor something many of us consider equally important or even more powerful, the way this institution welcomes a newcomer. 3 years ago, I would not have imagined myself standing up here, to be honest. Navrachna is a place we have grown to love. This is the place where the doors of the staff rooms can be flung open at the most inconvenient times to ask the most trivial doubts. This is the place where you can learn how to bargain by asking for a vada pav. This is the place where you are always greeted with the most evergreen smile. This is the place we now call home. And this is the place we soon step out from with a heavy heart, but eyes full of hope. Let it sink in for a second that the next time you might see the person seated next to you is in the newspapers, not far from today. The new decade beckons us, and I'm sure we all are geared up for the opportunities. Class of 2020, you inspire me, and everybody seated here. So yes, times will change, and the world will change you. But most importantly, I know you will change the world. Thank you, Navrachna, for making us who we are today. Thanking you and signing off, head boy Navrachna School Sama, Adarsh Sashidhar.
Thank you, Adarsh. May you all fare well in your career and accomplish all your dreams. I would now like to invite Ms. Saira Menon, class teacher 12F, to host her very own reality show, 12F's Got Talent.
Good evening, bonsoir, namaste. I, Saira Menon, class teacher 12F Humanities, warmly welcome you to the grand finale of the greatest reality show 2019-20, Class 12 has got talent. It has been a topsy-turvy 10 months of nail-biting, thrilling episodes with 30 eliminations to 12E on the way. A show where friendships were carved, skills were honed, and bonds were made. Apart from showcasing multitudes of talent, The contestants had a gala time playing musical tables in the dining hall, gracing the corridors with their esteemed presence, welcoming the new entrant plan Poku, and giving ready excuses when their mobile phones weren't confiscated. Irrespective of whoever emerges a winner today, the links of this chain of 29 will always remain fastened. Before the audience wonders when I plan to begin the show, let me take you to the stage without much ado. The first ones to come onto the stage are the impeccable icons, Vishwa, Priyanshi, Dia, and Shreya. Responsibility with them is indeed a trait. Meticulousness is a habit, nothing untoward, nothing great. Their creative inputs are a class apart, gracing the funfair and concert at all. Their notebook work is completed in the class, and the class logbook fetches all the good remarks. Excellence, thy name is impeccable ones. The movers and shakers of the class, they go great guns. All tasks they perform to the best of their ability. Such charming personalities, oh what gentility. Moving ahead, here come the shining divas, the fashionistas of the world of glitz and glamour. Shruti, Walisha, and Shazia. Fashion, whatever may be thy power, my girls hold you at ransom in their bower. They are a rare combination of beauty with brains. Chanel, Louis Vuitton, Dior, and Versace are the fashion houses where they want to be trained. Their footsteps they will follow, their dreams they will surely realize. With perseverance and hard work, they will definitely reach great heights. My wish for you is, may all your dreams come true. Truly great friends are hard to find, difficult to leave, and impossible to forget. True friendship is a gift that only a few get. Presenting before you the BFFs, Pushti Dhara, Tanvi Sanjana, Manasvi Antra. They can't think of a school day without their friend. So if you're looking for one, the other will definitely be there and then. That is the power of friendship they share. To each other, a helping hand they will always lend. Their spirits they will lift and perpetually try to mend. A shoulder to cry on, a hand to hold, the story of their friendship will always be told. Their laughter in the corridors will be now a things of the past, but their time spent at Navrachna will always stay close to their hearts. Music is life, that's why our hearts have beats, and where words fail, music speaks. Honoring the stage with their presence are the pitch-perfect queens, Khushi Agarwal and Ramya. Music finds an absolutely new meaning in the dictionary for these nightingales of Navrachna. Their mellifluous voices can enthrall one and all. A trained Bharatnatyam dancer and a Bharat Vikas Parishad award is backed by one. Performances in cafes with a band, the Soul Blues, gives immense satisfaction to the other one. Determination, dedication, and discipline are the mantras these girls live by. And mind you, in spite of their passion, academics too is something they swear by. Coming up next are the fabulous threesome, Mikhail, Mythil, and Tanmay. A potpourri of talent these artists portray, drama, suspense, popularity, simplicity, and innocence. You name it, and they have it. My classroom gets life from them. Everyone so unique, and yet so alike. Hilarious comments from one lightens any serious atmosphere. Literary discussions on books create the ambience of discussion from another. A smile is a response from the third to the questions put forth, and he is alert. Their radiant smiles can ease any discomfort, and they blend easily in the class. Please remember, even though there are majority of girls in my class. If a chocolate-flavored protein shake is the favorite of one, then innocence is the inherent charm of another. A never-say-die attitude, the never-give-up spirit, is the trait of the third. This adorable duo, Prakriti and Devyani, with a heart of gold, are one in a million. Always ready to lend a helping hand, a beacon of hope to all the students, guiding many with their projects, helping them in their timely submissions. Never do they take credit for their assistance. That's why they bear the title, Girls with a Golden Heart. They are goodness personified and are every teacher's delight. I could count on them on any day, so responsible are they. With these angels of mine around, the world will surely be a better one. Presenting before you the bubblicious backbenchers, Ruthvi, Kushi, Savi, Bhumi, and Mimansa. Dr. Abdul Kalam's statement, the best brains of the nation may be found on the last benches of the classroom, is so apt. These girls willingly occupy the last row. It is difficult to believe their concentration levels are only high when the back benches they occupy. But these girls have proved that front and back rows are just a myth. You can study wherever you wish. With books in hands and creative ideas in mind, they have created a kaleidoscope of memories to treasure and cherish. Last but not the least, coming up are the sports champs, Arushi, Meghavi, Jal, and Tasmay. These sports stars are the epitome of teamwork, leadership skills, and commitment. Full of vigor, vitality, and energy, they are the game changers with their synergy. Be it football or cricket, in CBSE Nationals or TOI, these sports champs have always vanquished their opposition and held true the motto of the school, fostering the spirit of excellence. They are the pride and the glory of the school. And now, after all these stage-shaking performances, comes the moment we all have been eagerly waiting for. The nail-biting, heart-beating moment of the result. The announcement of the winners. Oh wait, did I say winner or winners? Yes, winners. After looking at the amazing talent, the organizers have decided not to have any more eliminations and declare everybody a winner. So ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the very talented 29 performers. I will be back soon with the auditions for the next academic session 2020-21. Till then, au revoir, hasta la vista, till we meet again, goodbye and good luck.
Thank you, ma'am. Now we can proudly say that Navratna's got talent, a whole lot of it. We now request our vice principal, Ms. Kashmira Jaiswal, to come up on the podium for her segment celebrating the Student Council 2019-20.
Thank you, Shreya. Napoleon Bonaparte had mentioned that a leader is a dealer in hope. While all the while, I was under the impression that leadership is the art of getting someone else to do something you want done because he thinks he wants to do it. Fair warning, dear friends, do not study all these leadership books because those people who think they know everything are a great annoyance to those of us who do. Really? Like, really? The issue with leaders is that if you make people think they are thinking, they love you. But if you really make them think, they'll hate you. Jokes apart, the beautiful task given to me today is to acknowledge the efforts of the Student Council 2019-20 and the CBSE student coordinators for exhibiting exemplary leadership skills in all the projects executed by them in the year that went by in such a jiffy. The academician in me, however, compelled me to organize my thoughts based on my research on the various leadership styles. I've often been warned, Kashmira, don't take life too seriously. Nobody has ever got out of it alive. But here I am, putting my thoughts under the lens. So here we go. Dear Tejal ma'am, Suprabha ma'am, Mr. Shashidhar, Mrs. Shashidhar, parents, teachers, friends, warm greetings to you all. President Ananya Maheshwari exemplifies transformational leaders who motivate their team members because they expect the best from everyone. They set clear goals and they have good communication skills. RISE, Teachers Day, designing NavFest event that will see the light of in 2020 and all other school events were great examples of her inspiring leadership. Head girl Lisa Kesharia, she represents visionary leaders as they are inspiring. They tell their teams where they are heading, but encourage their team members to use their own initiative to solve a problem or meet a target. Empathy is the most important aspect of this soft-hearted leader. TEDx Student Talks this year was her baby, and she ensured that it succeeded big time. Head boy Adarsh Shashidhar, a democratic leader par excellence, believes in George S. Patton's words, don't tell people how to do things, tell them what to do and let them surprise you with their results. Democratic leaders make the final decisions, but they include team members in the decision-making process. His calm and collected demeanor while getting the student community support for all school events has been absolutely noteworthy. Sports captain Akash Pathak is an example of leaders using humor as their best strategy. My research points that the most effective leaders use humor to put people at ease, bring teams together, and see the light side of a sticky situation. Akash has always given a desi tadka of humor to lighten a sticky situation. Sports captain Rachel Ravikumar has often demonstrated service leadership style that she so often applies in her favorite field of sports as well. It involves leading team members to their personal success by coaching, mentoring, always focusing on the success of the team. Thank you. Cultural President Vishwa Joshi, where are you? Yeah. Vishwa validates strategic leadership, which is the ability to influence others to voluntarily make decisions for the team's success. During execution of the NavRISE, Vishwa exhibited potential to express a strategic vision for the entire event to the council and the school, enable them to pursue that vision with the help of right planning and right tools. Cultural President Deva Priya Shashwat exhibits a right mix of collaboration.